Here's a golden tip for you to engage in more physical activities and increase the frequency of your walks, for instance. I'm going to share with you a scientifically proven tip, alongside 11 benefits of walking. When you walk, 11 improvements can occur in your body, and that's what I'm going to explain in this video. I'm Dr. João. I'm an endocrinologist specializing in metabolism, which is fundamental to our health. Let's get started. Firstly, many of you have asked on the channel if just walking, without running or doing other activities, can compare to a gym workout. Does only walking help? And the answer is yes. There are multiple scientific studies validating the benefits of walking for your body. I have enumerated 11 benefits here, and as we go along, I'll also talk about the frequency. There will be some variations. You'll learn a lot in this video. Plus, I will also share with you a golden tip that's worth watching. What are the 11 benefits? Number one, it helps regulate blood pressure. People with high blood pressure or hypertension can have better blood pressure regulation by walking frequently. It also helps prevent high blood pressure. Why? Because physical exercise improves blood vessels' relaxation, which aids with pressure regulation. If you have high blood pressure, then walking is a good idea. In fact, it's not just good, you must walk. And how much is recommended? For physical exercise like walking, a total of 150 minutes of activity is recommended. Since you can adjust the intensity of your walk, if it's at a slightly higher intensity, with a quick pace, what happens? 150 minutes a week would be enough to have a positive impact on your blood pressure. If you opt for a slower stroll, you should aim for 250 minutes a week for a more substantial reduction in blood pressure and a decrease in cardiovascular risk. Sound good? So just walking does help. If I can only walk and I can't run, does it still help? Yes, it does. These total minutes I'm talking about, I've averaged from several scientific studies. So your doctor might recommend 210 minutes. These are rough estimates to give you an idea and a better understanding of the video and to confirm that walking indeed contributes to overall health. Second benefit, daily walking reduces the risk of thrombosis as it improves your circulation. It also helps with other issues like varicose veins, for example, but reducing the risk of thrombosis is already a significant reason for you to start walking. Guys, I didn't set a like target for this video because someone commented that doctors were not allowed to ask for likes on the video. So I won't be asking, but I am gonna set a goal of 11,000 likes. If you want to like it, then go ahead because there will be 1,000 likes for each tip as there are 11. So let's achieve this goal because this way, the system understands that the video is relevant and ends up recommending it to more people. I'm not asking for likes, as this person said, but let's attain this goal. Number three, cholesterol. And here I will say that walking can improve high-density lipoprotein cholesterol. It can increase good cholesterol and reduce bad low-density lipoprotein cholesterol, which also improves your cardiovascular risk. So walking helps a lot, yet I was informed that there's no way to lower cholesterol. There's no way to lower LDL. There's no way to increase good cholesterol. Is that true or false? We know that 70% of cholesterol is produced by the body itself, and 30% comes from diet and habits such as exercise. So you can reduce cholesterol by this 30% depending on your case. This 30% that you can modify would be enough for you to have a good cholesterol target. Saying cholesterol isn't bad is incorrect. You need cholesterol for cells to function, for example, and also for the production of certain hormones such as testosterone, vitamin D, or cortisol itself. Hormones that are fundamental to our lives. What's bad here is an excess of cholesterol, high cholesterol. Then you will have a greater cardiovascular risk. Number four, walking can help control diabetes or not. Here's the statement, walking helps control diabetes because you can have a metabolic improvement and it's been proven to have better control over blood sugar levels and glycemic levels. So it is one of the pillars of diabetes treatment. Physical exercise and walking assist you in this process. Number five, walking helps lower triglycerides. Many people have triglyceride issues, And physical activity is a strong ally in reducing triglycerides. I've discussed HDL cholesterol and LDL cholesterol, but when we're discussing triglycerides, you see a more pronounced improvement. So it's another reason for you to start walking. Number six, walking improves memory and mood. There are several studies, but this one on memory, I found very interesting. Who wouldn't want to have a better memory? I do. And you? That's why I walk. Number seven, walking can reduce your risk of death from all causes by up to 35% and your risk of having a stroke or heart attack by up to 40%. Here was a study. Actually, this study was done on steps. It was found that people who took more than 10,000 steps a day. But what is this in kilometers? It equates to around 8 kilometers per day. So it's not only about you heading out for a walk or walking on the treadmill, but it's more about those who walk more during the day, taking more than 10,000 steps or 8 kilometers. So there's this significant benefit. Number eight, and this benefit here will be of interest to billions of people because walking is very common. It can help treat fatty liver. It is one of the pillars in treatment as a metabolic disease. Just like diabetes, if you have fatty liver, it is essential that you take walk. Number nine, walking daily improves bowel movements. It's also beneficial for your intestines. Number 10, walking improves your vision because it helps prevent cataracts and glaucoma. Number 11, walking can decrease cancer risk. That's correct. You didn't misunderstand. The link between obesity and cancer has already been explored. There are more than 12 types of cancer that physical activity and metabolic improvement can help prevent. It can reduce risks of cancers such as breast cancer, bowel cancer, prostate cancer. So, walking is worth it. And I said I was going to give you a golden tip, also scientifically backed, for you to increase your walking frequency, set small goals for starting a physical activity. For example, today, I'm only going to walk for 1 minute. What do you mean? You started the video talking about 250 minutes or 150 if it's a more intense walk, and now you're talking about 1 minute. I'll explain. It is scientifically proven that if you set a small goal, like in this case 1 minute, you'll find fewer excuses, because if you set a goal of 1 hour, you will start to make excuses. Oh, but I have to cook dinner. I have to leave. I'm late already. So I'm going to walk tomorrow. If you set a smaller goal, like walking for 1 minute today, once you've completed that 1 minute, it's easier for you to keep exercising. Isn't it interesting how our brain works? But it's beneficial to set a small goal to start with, and then, as with many people, it's easy to keep exercising once you've started. So set small goals, and then once you've started exercising, you'll think to complete the remaining 50 minutes. Which will be much easier. If you're already doing it, comment below. Or if you're planning to start, I'll be overjoyed to read your comments, knowing that I've succeeded in helping you. What rating would you give this video, from 0 to 10? If it's 10, I'll produce more videos like this. Also, specify your city. Which part of the world are you from? I'm from Porto Alegre. I'm from Rio Grande do Sul. How about you? Many people from Portugal and even from Japan are here too. Now, I'm going to make a suggestion. Since I mentioned diabetes in this other video, I discuss 14 dangerous signs of diabetes. You'll learn much there too. If you like this video, that video is just right for you. Take care.